Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Can you believe that today is Thursday already? This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Happy Thursday, November the 4th. I don't know about you, but in the words of our forefathers and mothers, I thank God for waking me up this morning, starting me on my way. Grateful that the blood was running warm in my veins, I was clothed in my right mind, and so I'm grateful for just one more chance to say to God, thank you. How are you today? Won't you please come on? We're ready now to start our noonday prayer and devotional time. A couple of notices and announcements. Please be reminded that this Saturday is our walk run for Christ, rain or shine, our walk run for Christ, Salem on the move. I hope that you will plan to join us for that. It will start at 9 o'clock. We'll enter in at the Parkside Ocean Avenue entrance. So I'll be looking for you. Let me thank those of you who joined us for our World Day of Prayer on last evening. We had a wonderful World Day of Prayer. Over 75 people were on the call, and we know that God answers prayer. We know our world is in trouble, and we know that prayer is the key, and faith unlocks the door. Please join us on Sunday for our worship experience, on this Sunday, our worship experience, and then please join us in the afternoon at 2 o'clock, where we will celebrate our ushers. We'll have our ushers' annual sermon. I still continue to solicit your prayers for me. I'll be leaving on Sunday right after the usher's annual sermon, heading to Indianapolis, Indiana. Say goodbye to my surrogate father, the Reverend Dr. Melvin Gurdon. How he poured into my life, how he supported, and how heavy my heart is that I did not have the opportunity to fellowship more with him before God called him from labor to reward. Listen, take advantage of every day. Know that every day is a gift from God. Please remember those in our church that are sick and shut in. Sister Shirley Branch, Sister Frances Randolph, I visited with her yesterday. She's doing much better. Grateful for your prayers. Remember Sister Carolyn Ford. There may be others whose names I cannot call at the moment, but let's whisper a prayer. And then even in this COVID season, let's remember to reach out to someone. If you think about someone, then maybe just give them a call. You don't know what their state might be. Also, continue to pray for the family of Sister Shirley Braxton. We are now reported her as missing, and so we have to reach out to her. I have to get back to that person. That's probably somebody from Indianapolis trying to reach out to me, but right now we're into our prayer time. But really, if you think about someone, it's a reason that God probably brought them to your mind, then reach out to them and let them know that God loves them, that you're thinking about them. Don't wait for them to call you. Sometimes just a call, a word of encouragement will help somebody along the way. My office says, remember that we have a joint board meeting tonight at 7 o'clock. I'm looking for you, please. We're having an in-person joint board meeting tonight. I'll be looking for you to meet me here at 7 o'clock. We should not be that long, but there are some things that I need to discuss with you, because even in this COVID season, the Church of Christ must go forward, onward Christian soldiers, marching as to war with the cross before us. We must march on until victory is won, because the race is not given to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, but to all those who will hold out to the end. Well, let's go to the Word, and this is really the text that I'm sort of pondering to share for Dr. Gurdon's celebration. We've been studying out of 2 Timothy. This is Paul's final letter to his son Timothy, where he gives him counsel about the things that will happen in the church, also charges him to stay faithful to that he has been called to do, faithful to the gospel. In chapter 2 Timothy chapter 3, I want to start with verse 14 that would lead me right into chapter 4. So 2 Timothy chapter 3, starting with verse 14, it reads as following. In fact, everyone who wants to live a godly life in Christ will be persecuted, while evildoers and imposters will go from bad to worse, deceiving and being deceived. But as for you, continuing what you've learned and have become convinced of, because you know those from whom you learned it. In other words, continue in the faith, he says to his son, and to us by extension. He says, and how from infancy you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through Jesus Christ. If you want to be wise, then you got to read the Word of God. Then he says, all Scripture is God-breathed and useful for teaching, for rebuking, for correction, and training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. So if you're going to do God's work, you got to know God's word. You got to consult the manual. I mean, when you get a new car, don't you read the manual? You get a new stove, you read the manual. You get a new phone, you read the manual. Then this book, the Word of the Living God, is our manual for life. And then Paul says, in the presence of God and Jesus Christ. And this is the reason why we do this. This is really, in a sense, the Trinity, God and Jesus Christ. Jesus says, I and the Father are one. If you've seen me, you've seen the Father. And Paul says, in the presence of God and Jesus Christ, who will judge the living and the dead, and in view of his opinion, of his appearing and his kingdom. Paul has gotten a glimpse of the coming of Christ, of the second coming of Christ. And he says, in view of his appearing and in view of the kingdom of God, I give you this charge. Preach the word. Be prepared in season and out of season. There's some seasons that will be good. Some seasons are like summer and the flowers and spring and things bud, and there's joy, there's pastor's anniversaries, there's good fellowship for you, everything is going well, that's a good season. And then sometimes seasons are not so good. We're out of the good season and we're into another season, season of fall and winter, people fall away and things don't go right, he says, but no matter what, preach this word. In good times and in bad times, continue to preach the word. Correct. Let people know when they're wrong. I know some of you will not be so happy with me tonight, but it is my assignment to give correction as God gives me direction. And Paul reminds us in 1 Corinthians chapter 4, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels. We preach not ourselves, but that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. But we still have a responsibility as God gives us utterance to correct, to rebuke, to let you know that some things are just not acceptable, and to encourage, because we know that with God, all things are possible. And without him, I could do nothing. Without him, my life would be just like a ship without a sail. He says, but when you do these things, do it with great patience and careful instruction. Pray for me. I pray for you. And this also is what you have to do as it relates to your family, to your children, to your household. We all have a responsibility. And it's as if he's speaking to us right now. He says, for the time will come when they will not put up with sound doctrine. Instead, to suit their own desires, they will gather around them a great number of teachings to say what their itching ears want to hear. They will turn their ears away from the truth and turn aside to myths. We see that happening today. Whoever would have thought that in Washington, D.C., there would be as much talk and as much, confirmation of the big lie as it is of the truth. Even in Virginia, the governor won on a big lie as he talked about critical race theory. Critical race theory is not even taught in the public school system. But that was a dog whistle to say that we should not teach the complete history about what happened to people of color. And so he got people frightened, and it charged up the base for Donald Trump. And they went out and they voted for him, because people sometimes will have to their ears, itching ears, and they will be attracted to people who will say what they want to hear. But he says to his son Timothy and to us by extension, but you keep your head in all situations. Be alert. Keep your head. Don't lose control. Do a pre-check. Pray before you speak. Think about it. Endure hardship, because trouble will come. Jesus says, in the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I've overcome this world. Do the work of an evangelist. That is the same thing that he says in verse 2, preach the word. Continue to share this gospel. That word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. Discharge all the duties of your ministry. And then Paul knows that he has to check out, that God is calling him from labor to reward. But he says, for I am already being poured out like a drink offering, and the time of my departure is at hand. I fought a good fight. Paul says, I didn't fight just some raggedy fight. I didn't fight a fight that was not purposeful, but I fought a good fight. I gave it all that I had, Paul says. And then he knows that the race is not given to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, but to those who have endured to the end. He says, I have finished the race. Time comes and we'll call from labor to reward. He says, but in doing so, I kept the faith. Without God, I could do nothing. Without him, I would fail. Without him, my life would be rugged, just like a ship without a sail. I've kept the faith. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. But one that comes to God must believe that he is. He is reward of those who diligently seek him. And he says, I know, I close now, that there's laid up for me, there's in store for me a crown of righteousness, a sign of victory, the emblem of being victorious, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award me on that day. I'm not even worried about it. And when before the throne I stand, I'll lay my trophies down, all down at his feet. Because Jesus paid it all, and all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, but he washed it white as snow. And then Paul is not selfish about this thing. He says, because not to me only, but to all those who love God and who longs for his appearing. The word of God for the people of God, thanks be to God. Thank you so much for joining me. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear God, for this time together, we give you thanks, and for your word that's so pregnant with truth and power that gives birth as we yet try to understand it. Help us to hide your word in our heart that we might not sin against you. Help us to be purposeful and intentional about running the race, about keeping the faith, knowing that you have said in your word that we walk uprightly before you, that no good thing with you will hold from us. Bless each person under the sound of my voice. Meet each of us at our point and at our need. We love you, we praise you, we adore you, we magnify you, and we give you glory. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, thank you so much. Let me go ahead and greet some of you now, and then we will move on with the rest of our day. Wanda, how are you? Sister Angela Kelly, so glad to know that you're home. Please pray for her. She had surgery, but it was successful, and we give God praise, honor, and glory for you. Brenda, how are you? Sister Deborah Dunham, how are you? Richard Fagan, thank you for joining with us. Mary Lawrence, glad that you're back. Maxine, always good to see you. Sister K Woman, how are you? Sister Mary Joseph, hope you're feeling better. We continue to pray for you. We know that God is a healer. Angela, how are you? Great job with the World Day of Prayer on yesterday. God bless you. Sister Shirley Millard, how are you? Sister Christina Murray, how are you? I'm glad to see you. Glad to see all you. Valerie, how are you? Good to see each and every one of you. Thank you so much. Meet me here tomorrow at the same time. All right. God bless you. Let's receive the benediction. And I will see you tomorrow. Our board members, I'll see you tonight. Now unto him who's able to keep you from falling, present you faultless before his presence with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, to him be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.